Dear students, I am Santan, working as a physics faculty in Target English Medium School. Today, in this short video, I would like to explain about what are the uses of hydraulic machine. From the chapter of floating bodies, in 9th standard level in our state syllabus. In our previous video, I clearly explained about what is Pascal's law and what is the hydraulic machine and what are the principles involved in it. That is, I will explain. One second, listen very carefully before going to our topic. So, Pascal's law is nothing. Okay, how to define that one means when pressure acting at any point in a confined boundary of liquid, it is equally transmitted in all directions. That is the Pascal's law. Based on the Pascal's law, so the further sentence will be concept the which one? Hydraulic machine. Hydraulic machine is a it is a machine. So what are the principle is involved in that machine means a smaller force is acting on a smaller area is equal to large force is acting on a larger area. That is one. Okay, small force is acting on a smaller area is equal to large force is acting on a larger area. So that is the meaning of that one is there. Okay. So means we know that F2 is equals to F1 upon A1 into A2 we are getting. A2 is transferred to this side. Okay. So F2 upon A2 is equals to F1 upon A1. Or it is we should be write that F1 upon A1 is equals to F2 upon A2. So what is the meaning of this one? Force act means A1 is the smaller area in the previous diagram, A2 is the larger area. F1 is the smaller force, F2 is the larger force. That's why smaller force is acting on the smaller area is always equal to large force is acting on the larger area. That's why with help of this formula you can easily understand it. So is this correct or not? But the same way in that one, which law is involved? Pascal's law is involved in the working of hydraulic machine. But the hydraulic machine will be modified into the different ways for various purposes. Okay. So what are that one means? So means hydraulic machines are types. We are used observed in the different modes. Okay. Like hydraulic jock, hydraulic lift, hydraulic brakes, like this mode. So the hydraulic machine is modified into the other ways for various purposes, like hydraulic jug, hydraulic lift, and hydraulic brakes. Applications are uses of hydraulic machine. Sometimes they ask in that application mode or sometimes uses, but the answer is the same. It is used to compress the cotton bales in cotton industry. It is used to extract oil from seeds. It is used to make punch holes on iron sheets. It is used to make punch holes on iron sheets. It is used in automobile services like hydraulic jack, it is used as a brake in vehicles for effective stopping of the vehicle. So listen, what are the applications of hydraulic machine means? Okay, these are some of. Okay, hydraulic machine is used to compress the cotton bales in cotton industry. Hydraulic machine is used to extract oil from oil seeds. It is used to make punch holes on iron sheets in iron industry. It is used in automobile services like, okay, as a hydraulic jack. It is used as brakes in vehicle for effective stop. Okay. So these are the main applications or uses of hydraulic machine. So one by one, I will try to explain simply for understanding of you. So here, listen. It is the hydraulic machine. We know that this type of way we are observing that to extract to compress the cotton bales. We know that to make the yarn from the cotton for textiles purpose. We know that in textile industry, actually cotton is available in the cotton plugs. The cotton plugs we can make into the bales, means larger one, like a flat. That's why what we can do, with help of the hand, it is not possible to make into the flathead for easily removing the air from that. That's why what they are doing there. So it is a one platform is there. Okay, it is the cube piston, it is the bay piston. So on the lower, on this platform, they keep the which one cotton plugs. okay, one side of the particle box will be K. It is a basic support. Here one, okay, hole is there. Through that one, one type of way is there. Through that way, they keep which one cotton plugs inside. After that is closed. The residue one. So here you are observing that when the force is applied on the piston P, it will be moved to downward slowly. Then it will be moved to which direction? Upward direction. That's why. So this platform. This platform is connected to the Q piston. That's why this huge pressure will be acting on the Q piston. Then the Q piston will be slowly moved up. That's why this platform is also moving upward and go fastly and contact with which one? Rigid surface. That's why what will happen? What are the cotton plugs are there here? These cotton plugs will be fastly go and touches to this one. So by applying the huge force between them, then what will happen? Make into the flat. That is one. Okay. So like the same mode. Okay. So another one is oil sheets. So oil sheets are all will be kept here in this one. So the Q piston will be moved vertically upward when you apply the force on the P piston. So this oil sheets will be moved forward vertically. So these both platforms and these two are rigid one. So upper one is the fixed one, lower one is the mobile one. That's why mobile one and upper one. So our fixed one, both are strongly attached with each other by forcing this one. Then what will happen? So what are the oil sheets are there on the mobile one? So these two are the oil sheets. High pressure will be acting during the both are contact. At that time, the oil will become outside from the sheets. That oil will be passing through the spout or overflow and collecting into the jar. Or huge is there one type of arrangement simply. So this is the one of the way to extract, means hydraulic machines are used to extract oil from oil sheets. So hydraulic machine is used as a punching hole in which one? Iron industry. Same thing more is there as usual like this one. Okay. So but here what will be happen in this one? For example, it is an iron sheet. The iron sheet will be kept onto the mobile platform and on the upper portion, what will be happen? Okay. So the sharp teeth are there. Now on the iron sheet we can make the hole at these three places or different places. Based on that we are using like this. That's why when force is applied on the P piston, it is moved to down, it is moved up, and this iron sheet will go fastly and touch this one. These are the very strong rigid sharp knives are there. That's why so this iron sheet will go to touch that one immediately. They make the fine holes. So this is the way of the method to punch the holes on iron sheets in iron industry. And also hydraulic machine is used as a hydraulic jack or in the auto service mobile. A car is there, car will be lifted to particular height for washing or any one parts are there to remove and attach the new one like everything at the lower portion. What will happen? So they must be lifted to above our eyes. That's why. So to lift the car, it is not easily possible. Or to lift the any truck, it is not easily possible. That's why what will happen? We are using the hydraulic machine. In the hydraulic machine, jerk is nothing but lifting like that one. That's why they lifted the vehicle easily by acting a large force on this one. It will be slowly move. That's why you can easily see the lower portion of the car or truck from the downward. So that's why you can easily find out that, and you can easily wash that one or service. So these are the topics are involved, okay, in the chapter of which one, floating bodies. Just I will give a brief idea what are the topics we are discussing, okay, in the chapter of floating bodies. So in the starting of the chapter, we clearly discuss about what is the density, what are the SI and CHS units of density, and what some of the materials density values also we discuss. Further we discuss about relative density and okay some numericals about how to find relative density or density of an object. Further we are discussing that what is the pressure is acting in the okay on a body when kept just beneath the surface or inside the liquid, and what is the atmospheric pressure, what is the value of atmospheric pressure, how we can find, and which instrument or which device we are used to measure the atmospheric pressure, nothing but barometer. So the pressure inside the liquid at any point we can measure it with help of the okay manometer device. And further we are discussing that what is the Archimedes principle, how to find relative density of a solid if its density is greater than the water, and how to find relative density of a solid if its density is lesser than the water, like a car, with help of the Archimedes principle. And finally we discuss that what is the Pascal's law, what is the hydraulic motion, how which principle is involved here, how it is working, and what are the applications or uses of hydraulic motion. So this type of topics mainly we discuss entire this chapter. Okay, thank you.